All. Next scheduling algorithm is disk scheduling algorithm. In case of disk scheduling algorithm, we have to calculate the seek time. So what, first of all, let us consider what is meant by seek time. Seek time means the time required to move your read write head from one location to another location. So this is a given data, or there are available different disk scheduling algorithms: FCFS, SSTF, scan and C-scan. FCFS is first come first serve, SSTF is shortest seek time first algorithm, scan algorithm, and C-scan means circular scan algorithm. So let us evaluate all these algorithms with the help of one example. So the given example is, given the following track request in the disk queue, compute for the head movement of read write head, and these are the given read write head positions to, or we have to visit all these positions with the help of read write head. And one more given data is, consider that the read write head position at location 50, means initially your read write head is available at this location, means 50. So let us start with computation with the help of first FCFS algorithm. First come, first serve. So this is the given sequence we have to consider in this sequence for read-write-head position. So first visit from 50 to 95. So let us assume that here is your 95, then 95 to 180. So this is your 180, then 180 to 34. This is your 34 position. So this is the track position. After that 34 to again 119 here, because 120. So next 119, after that 11. So 11 is here. So next 11, after that is 123 again here is the 123. So after 11, your read write head again move towards 123. After that 62, 62 is here, so 62. After that again 64 is here. So this is your read write head is going to move from one location to another location. So how you are going to calculate the seek time or average seek time for this particular FCFS algorithm? For that particular purpose, we are going to perform this calculation. So these are nothing but head positions your read write head visited. So first of all, your read write head visited to 95, after that 180, 34 in this sequence. So let us assume that data. So first of all 95, then 180, then 34, next one be the 119, next one 11, next 123, next 62 and 64. So total 8 different positions visited by your read write head. Next one, so how you are going to calculate the time required to move from one location to another? So this is your initial position, and from this initial position to this 95, this is your seek time. So how you are going to calculate that seek time? So 95 minus 50 is the time required to move your read write head from one position to another. So here calculate, first of all 95 minus 50 is 45. Next one, 180 minus 95, 180 minus 95 is be the 85. So according to that, evaluate this all track positions. So 182, from 182 34. So 180 minus 34 is 146. Next 119 minus 34 is 85. Next 119 minus 11 is 108. Next 123 minus 11 is 112. Next 123 minus 62 is equal to 61. Next 64 to 62, 64 minus 62 is equal to 2. So we have calculated this track position, means 180 minus 95, 180 minus 34, next 119 minus 34, 119 minus 11, 123 minus 11, next 123 minus 62, and 64 minus 62. So this is the time required to move from one position to another position. So we are going to calculate the sum for this, all this total computation, and the sum is 644. So this is the seek time, normal seek time. So how you are going to calculate average seek time? So average sick time is equal to 644 minus 8. So total number of positions or total number of heads is visited by your retired head divided by 8 is equal to 80.5 is the average sick time for your first come first serve algorithm. So let us evaluate second algorithm SSTF for the same data, and the data is in the form like, first of all, your retired head position visited. Okay, first of all is your 95. So SSTF, so what is the logic behind SSTF? SSTF means shortest sick time first. So the given current retired position is 50. So how you are going to calculate shortest sick time first? So according to given data, you are going to find out shortest sick time first with respect to this 50. So from this 50, who is the nearest retired head position? So I think in the left hand side is the 34 and right hand side is the 62. So nearest track is 64, because from 50 to 62 only 12 tracks are required for movement, and from 50 to 34 there are required 26 tracks. So we are going to consider shortest sick time. So from 50 to next nearest is your 62, after that 62 to next one be the 64 is the nearest. Next, from 64 left hand side is the 34 and right hand side is the 95. So for the left hand side sick time is 30 and for 95 sick time is 31. So shortest sick time is 34. So from this 64 you are going to consider here as the 34. So next shortest sick time is 11 from this 34, because 11 is the next, and from that 11 you are going to consider the next is the your 95. So 95 is the next, after that again 119 from 95 is the 119, again from that 119 to next is 123, again from 123 to last is 180. So this is the given, according to given data we have drawn this SSTF shortest graph. After that we will calculate the average sick time for this SSTF. So from this 50 the next track visited is 62, so next one is 64, next one is 34, next one is 11, next one is 95, next one is 119, next 123, and last be the 180. So track positions or track time is 62 minus 50, next 64 minus 62, next 64 minus 34, next 34 minus 11, next 95 minus 11, next one be the 119 minus 95, next one is 123 minus 119, and last one is 180 minus 123. So according to that calculate the sick time. So first 62 minus 50 is 12, next one is 2, next one is 30, 23, 95 minus 11 is 84, next one is 24, next one is 4, next one is 50. So 180 minus 123 is 57, 180 minus 123 is 57. So this is the sick time from one position to another. So total sick time for all these tracks is 236. So average sick time for all these experiment or all these nodes is 2236 minus 8 is equal to 29.5. So in case of SSTF, average sick time is 29.5, and in case of FCFS, the total average sick time is 80.5. Next, third disk scheduling algorithm is SCAN. So in case of SCAN, read write head is going to consider only one position. If you are going to consider left to right position, so he is going to only scan from left to right. First of all, he is going to consider from this 52 left all nodes, and from that 0 he is going to consider all the right nodes. Means he is going to consider zigzag position, left to right or right to left. So here in this case, for scan we are going to consider a right to left position. So 50 is our initial position for this scan. So 50, from that 50, if you are going to consider right hand side, so who is the next right hand side frame is the next 62. So from this 50, here we are going to consider 62. From that 62, next right hand side node is 64. From that 64, next one is your 95. So here is your 95. From that 95, next one be your 119. This is your 119. After that 119, next is 123. After that 123, next right hand side is 180. So this is 180. So we have scanned left to right. Next we are going to consider right to left scanning. So after that, next node we are going to consider is 34 from left right position. After that 34, we are going to consider 11 because all the nodes are visited here. So next node is 34 for next visit. So this is 34 from this 180, and after that 34, next one is 11. So this is 11. So all the 8 nodes are visited with the help of this scan. So similar with respect to FCFS and scan, we are going to calculate the average seek time for this particular experiment. So from this 50, next node visited is 62, 64, 95. According to that, we are going to mention here data 62, 64, next 95, after that 119, then next 123, next 180, next 34 and 11, 34 and 11. So the seek time is 62 minus 50, 64 minus 62, 95 minus 64, 119 minus 95. Similarly, 62 minus 50, next 64 minus 62, 64 minus 62, next 95 minus 64, next 119 minus 95, 119 minus 95, next 123 minus 119, 123 minus 119, next 180 minus 123, 180 minus 123, next 180 minus 34, 180 minus 34, and last 34 minus 11, 34 minus 11. So calculate the average seek time is the 12, 2, 24, next 5 minus 5 is 30, is 1, and 31 is 24. Next is your 4, next 57, next 146, and next the 23. So total seek time is 299, and average seek time for this particular scan algorithm is 299 divided by 8 is 37. This is the average seek time for this particular scan algorithm. Let us move towards next algorithm is C-scan. Next algorithm is your C-scan. So what is the difference between scan and C-scan? In scan, we have considered zigzag position, means position from left to right and right to left with the next track. So in case of C-scan, here we are going to consider only single position or single movement or single direction. For example, if you are going to consider left to right direction, so in case of second iteration, again you have to consider left to right position. So let us evaluate with the help of this example. So initial position is our 50. So again same, here we are going to consider left to right. So left, next node is 62 from 50. Next is 64. So 62, again 64. From that 64, your next node is 95, then 119, 123 is your 95, then 119, next 123. 123, next is over 180. So this is similar with scan algorithm. What is the main difference? In case of scan, we have considered next, if we have considered here, we have considered left to right, then in case of scan we are going to consider right to left, but here we are going to consider again left to right, means directly move towards left position, and your left node is 11. So directly move towards 11 and then move towards again right is the 34. Means here in this case we are going to consider only single direction, left to right and left to right. Again for next visit you are again you are directly going to consider from this right hand position to again left hand position. So again we have visited all the 8 nodes. So calculate the again average seek time. So visited nodes in the sequence 62, 64, again 95, 119, 123, 180, next 11 and last 34. Here up to it's very similar with respect to scan. So calculate the again track position similar with this 62 minus 50, 62 minus 50, 64 minus 62, 95 minus 64. 64 minus 62, 95 minus 64, 119 minus 95, 123 minus 119, 180 minus 123, 180 minus 11. Instead of 34 here we are going to consider 11, and last one is 34 minus 11. So calculate the seek time for each and every node is your 12 to 31, 24, 4, 57, then 169 and 23. So total average seek time, so total time is 3322. So average seek time for this algorithm is 322 divided by 8 is equal to 40.25. so we have covered all this for algorithms. So finally we are going to compare all the algorithms. So FCFS, the average seek time is 80.5. in case of SSTM, average seek time is 29.5. for scan is 37.37 and for C-scan is 40.25. so according to our iteration, C-scan is the best algorithm for evaluation purpose in case of disk scheduling algorithm. Thank you.